Lovely. Hello. That was Hello Operator and Oosh. Yes. So thank you, Max, for your permission to share your music. I like it anyway, and my boy likes it, and their drummer, Eddie, is just ace. So welcome if you are joining live. Welcome if you are watching later. Welcome to the many new members that we have over the last couple of days. Do introduce yourself, if you wish, via a written piece about you or a little 30-second video, whatever you feel. So I hope you will all be saps. Now, if you've read the about section for this group, you'll know what a sap is, or maybe you won't, but I'll come back to that in a minute. So tonight we have a watch party. I'm going to try and get my head around how you do that. Should be pretty straightforward, I think. So Barking Tales, which is a mental health comedy club hosted by the hilarious Harriet. And she has got Mark Watson on tonight, big star. So you can watch that along with us for free, donate if you wish. And that's 8 o'clock tonight. You can watch it along with me and whoever else is going to be here on this group. So how are you feeling? There's a poll. I've put a poll on the page today, and there's been some interesting responses actually about your emotions around the current lockdown, corona crisis. I was expecting a lot more people to say they were feeling very anxious and fearful, but mostly positive at the moment. So do keep selecting which of those statements best fits how you're feeling at the minute. I'm curious to see what the measure is at the moment. What's the mood? So, a SAP, what is a SAP? A SAP is someone who shares, advocates, and participates. So it would be really good if you could all share the link to this group page, please, rather than inviting all of your friends from Facebook. I've got about 300 requests to join now, and I really don't know if the people want to be here or not, so I don't want to let them in if actually they've got no interest. So please just post a link to this group page, either on your Facebook page or via Instagram, or send it to your friend via text message, whatever you want to do. We've got about 136 people here now, I think. So if each of you introduce one person, one of your friends, family, colleagues, whoever they are, joins, we'll then have 272. And if each of you introduce 10 people, we'll then have 1,500 people in this lovely community. And I believe the average number of Facebook friends that we have is about 400. So if all of us could get 400 people in here that actually want to be here, then we'd have 54,000 people in this community. How wonderful would that be? Imagine the amount of support we could give and receive, how much knowledge we could spread, how much love we could spread, how much compassion. All these wonderful guests we've got coming in, they can benefit from all of those free sessions that these folks are offering, the benefit of their expertise, their experience, and their skills. So do be a SAP. S is for share. Please share by sending the link to the group to all of your people and let them in, let them all in. So the A is advocate. SAP, share, advocate. That means, you know, if you've learned something from the group, if there's something that's inspired you from the group, then be an advocate. Get out there and shout about it. We've got a sound healing session tomorrow with Rachel Waite, and there'll be probably lots of people in the world that have no knowledge of sound healing. They might be really skeptical of it. If you benefit from it, if you think it's a wonderful thing, advocate for it. Tell people, you want to try this, you want to get in this group, you want to go and see Rachel, you want to do all these wonderful things. It's good for your mental health, it's good for your well-being. So be an advocate. And finally, P is participate. So leave comments, share resources. Helen, you shared a great resource today. Thank you very much for that, Action for Happiness. Anything that you think is going to be useful in supporting the other members of this community, get it out there, participate. Likewise, if you need some support, if you want something from me, from the group, from whoever it is, put it out there. You know, this is a safe, non-judgmental community. That's the idea. This is why I've set it up, is for people to come here, get support, give support, learn about stuff, find some resources. There'll be some paid courses and stuff coming up. But mostly it is to connect with people, to share stuff and support each other. This is a tricky time. And even when there isn't a blooming coronavirus thing going around, life can be tricky. So let's participate. Let's do our bit. The group isn't just about me saying stuff. It's what we all make it. So I invite you humbly to do your bit as well and share what you can bring to this group. Thank you very much. That's what a SAP is. I hope you'll all become SAPs. And if you're a bit shy, don't worry, maybe you'll be less shy tomorrow or next week. So, equanimity. I'm going to do a meditation shortly to cultivate some equanimity. And I wonder what equanimity is. When I was writing the Successfully Navigating Home Working resource, one of my friends, Jack, hello, Jack, proofread an early copy for me, and I'd put equanimity in there, and she said, don't use that word, people won't know what it means. Thank you, Jack, good tip. So I'm going to explain what equanimity means in case you don't know. It basically means being comfortable with how things are. So accepting this as reality and not fighting against it, not trying to push it away, just not judging it as good or bad, just being mindfully zen accepting. Okay, so to illustrate this, I shall share one of my favorite parables, which is a Taoist tale from China. I believe it's an ancient thing, but it might be one of those fake news things that somebody made up about a year ago. I don't know. Anyway, I find it effective. So the story in a nutshell, if I can get this right, is there is a China. No, there isn't. I'll start again. There is a farmer in China, and his most valuable asset is his horse, because he uses that to plow his fields and do all the other things that horses do on farms. And one day, the horse runs away, and his neighbor says, "Oh, that's so terrible for you. What terrible luck. And you must fall into poverty now, because you won't be able to plow your fields and you won't be able to take your goods down to the market," and all that shenanigans. The farmer, with equanimity, simply responds, "I don't know if it's good. I don't know if it's bad. Could be good fortune, could be bad fortune. All I know is that the horse is gone." And then a few days later, the horse returns. And guess what? It's got another six horses with it. It's brought these six wild horses from the forest or wherever he found them. And the neighbor goes, "Brilliant. Wow, what great fortune you've had. You've now got seven horses. You must feel so rich and lucky." And the farmer, with equanimity once again, just said, "Could be good, could be bad. Not going to judge it. Who knows? All I know is I now have seven horses in my stable." And then a couple of days later, his son, who works on the farm, is having a ride on one of the wild horses, trying to tame it, trying to break it in, I think is the expression. And he gets thrown by this wild horse and breaks his leg. And the neighbor says, "Oh gosh, what bad luck, your poor son. That's a terrible thing to happen." And the wise farmer, with equanimity, says, "Could be good, could be bad. Who knows? I ain't gonna judge it." And sure enough, the very next day, the military march into town, and they're conscripting young, fit, able young men to join the war effort because there's a war on. And the boy can't go because he's broken his leg. And so it goes on. You get the picture. We don't know what's good or bad. When events like this coronavirus thing happens, we don't actually know what's the future holds. There could be some good things, there could be some bad things. All we know is there's a virus. Yeah. So if you can face that with equanimity, just accept it, don't push it away, try not to be anxious about it, try not to see it as a good thing or a bad thing, you can come into a very peaceful place of acceptance. So what we're going to do is try and practice some equanimity with a meditation. Which I hope you will join in with, either live if you're doing it now or later on at your leisure, should you be watching this back later, and hopefully not at the same time as watching the comedy show at 8 o'clock. So, what we're going to do is begin with some calming breaths. So I invite you to sit yourself upright with your feet on the floor, planted firmly. Have your back straight, but not tense. So alert, but not holding any tension. You can lie down if you wish. And start with some lovely calming breaths. Slow, deep breaths. Try counting to five as you breathe in, all the way into your stomach. And try and make your out breath the same length. So in for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And slowly released for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, breathing in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, filling the lungs up, and gradually out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just do a few more of those on your own, counting in your head, breathing deep into your belly, filling the lungs. And as you breathe out, feel the tension release, relaxing. As you breathe out, in for 5, all the way in, and out for 5. is do a couple more of those. Hopefully you're feeling calm and grounded. And one more deep breath in for five, and out for five. Okay, now if you just concentrate on your heart center, return your breath to its normal rhythm. Try not to control it. Just notice it, notice the breath in your heart area. And think about, as a human being, you may well have desires to serve others and to serve yourself. You may wish for happiness for yourself and for others. You may wish for yourself to be free from suffering and for others to be free from suffering. You may wish to be compassionately serving the needs of your friends, your family, the wider world. And whilst you're acknowledging that, also acknowledge that as well as joy, compassion in the world, there also exists suffering. There are kindness and good deeds, and there are also difficult, challenging situations and evil, harmful deeds. As you continue to breathe into your heart center, recognize the necessity of trying to balance your wish to make positive change in the world with the reality that you can't control things that are going on outside of you. You can't control the actions of others. You can't control the spread of a virus. You can't control anything other than your own actions, words, and reactions, how you respond to what is happening outside of you. So continue to breathe into your heart center. And bring to mind the image of someone who you don't have any strong feelings about, negative or positive. It might be someone you pass in the street, could be a shopkeeper, could be a neighbour that you don't know very well. And when you've chosen someone, keep them in your mind's eye. And repeat the following mantras. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. Suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to experience and not by the experience itself. Suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to experience, not by the experience itself. And still with the image of that person in your mind, repeat the mantra, although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Still breathing into your heart center with this person in your mind's eye. Finally, repeat the mantra. May you not be caught in reactivity. May you not be caught in reactivity. We are practicing here to cultivate equanimity, not judging things as good or bad, just accepting what is. So take a deep breath in, all the way into your belly, and slowly breathe out. Shift your attention now to someone who you might see as a benefactor. So maybe a mentor, a carer, someone who takes care of you, a teacher, a friend, a family member, or one of those many unseen workers who keep society working, especially in this crisis. So it could be a member of the NHS staff. So if you know somebody like that, someone who is offering benefit to yourself or to wider society, keep them in your mind's eye. And breathing into your heart center, you can repeat the following mantras either out loud or just in your mind, as whichever you prefer. So as you contemplate this benefactor, all beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. Suffering or happiness is created through one's relationship to experience, not by experience itself. Suffering or happiness is created through one's relationship to experience, not by the experience itself. Still breathing into your heart center with this benefactor in mind. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Still breathing into your heart center, thinking about this benefactor in your mind's eye. May you not be caught in reactivity. May you not be caught in reactivity. And take another deep breath into your belly, counting to five as you do so, and slowly release and feel tension dissipating as you breathe out for a count of five. And this time, I'd like you to bring to mind a loved one, someone that it's very easy to have a relationship with, a positive relationship with, an uncomplicated, loving relationship. So it could be your partner, could be a child, friend, a pet. And with this being in your mind's eye, silently or out loud, repeat these mantras whilst concentrating your breath on your heart center. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. Still breathing into your heart center with this loved one in your mind's eye. Repeat the mantra, suffering or happiness is created through one's relationship to experience, not by experience itself. Suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to experience, not by the experience itself. Still focusing on breathing into your heart center with this loved one in your mind's eye. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. And still breathing into your heart center with this loved one in your mind's eye. May you not be caught in reactivity. May you not be caught in reactivity. Okay, and now deep breath in for a count of five all the way into your belly. And exhale slowly for a count of five. And this time I'd like you for a final time to bring someone different into your mind's eye. And I'd like it to be could be somebody you have recently had an argument with, could be a colleague or boss at work with whom you don't have a great relationship. I When you have that person in your mind's eye, continue breathing into your heart center. And out loud or silently, repeat the mantras. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. All beings like yourself are responsible for their own actions. Suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to experience, not by experience itself. Suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to experience, not by the experience itself. Still breathing into your heart center with this person in your mind's eye that you have a difficult relationship with. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Although I wish only the best for you, I know that your happiness or unhappiness depends on your actions, not on my wishes for you. Finally, still breathing into your heart center with this person in your mind's eye, may you not be caught in reactivity. May you not be caught in reactivity. And take a deep breath in to your belly for a count of five again. And relaxing as you breathe out. And maybe just reflect on how easy or difficult that exercise was. Maybe you found it easier to accept that with those people we have a difficult relationship with, it's easier to separate responsibility for their happiness and draw a boundary to say, I am not responsible for this person's happiness. Maybe it was more difficult for you to acknowledge that for someone who you feel is a benefactor, or someone who is a loved one who you have an uncomplicated, loving relationship with. So whatever your experience was, just notice the reactivity that you had. And maybe you can bring some equanimity to your reactivity. So not judging it as good or bad, just accepting that that is the reality and being comfortable with that. Finally, take one more deep breath in, five, count to five all the way into your belly. Breathing out slowly again. And this time, let's broaden the reach. So that we're now encompassing the whole world, all beings in the world, including all animals, all the creatures. Try to keep that in your mind's eye, whilst inwardly or quietly outwardly repeating the mantras. All beings are responsible for their own actions. Bring yourself into the picture as well. Embrace yourself in this equanimity. All beings, including myself, are responsible for their own actions. Suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to experience, not by experience itself. For everybody in the world, including myself, suffering or happiness is created through our relationship to the experience, not by the experience itself. Although I wish only the best for all beings, I know that their happiness or unhappiness depends on their actions, not my wishes. Although I wish only the best for myself, I know that my happiness or unhappiness depends on my actions, not my wishes for myself. Still breathing into your heart center, silently or out loud, repeating the final mantra. May all beings not be caught in reactivity. May I not be caught in reactivity. Take another deep breath, counting in for five as you breathe all the way deep into your belly. And breathe out, relaxing and releasing for a count of five. And as a final exercise, can you contemplate equanimity in regard to yourself? Perhaps you notice that taking responsibility for your own happiness or unhappiness was the hardest of all. We are all responsible for our own happiness or unhappiness. And with equanimity, accepting the situation as it is, accepting that we don't have control over anything apart from our own actions and how we respond. And with that equanimity can come peace and freedom, regardless of whether the circumstances we find ourselves in we label as pleasant or unpleasant. Just like the Taoist parable, the farmer there didn't know what changes were going to happen in his life. He didn't know what the consequences would ultimately be. But approaching the situation with equanimity allows for the mystery of things to unfold. The unknowable, uncontrollable nature of things, just accepting them as they are. And that is where our power is, that's where our peace is, that's where our freedom is, regardless of the external circumstances. And in this current difficult situation, strange situation we find ourselves in, perhaps we can practice equanimity and accept that we have so little control over what is happening and what is going to happen. We can sit with that equanimity and accept it. We can learn to let go of the need to control, and let go of anxiety about the future. All beings everywhere are responsible for their own actions. They're responsible for their own response. And without this recognition, we may fall into burnout of trying to help too many people when it is not our responsibility to do so. Or we may fall into deep anxiety or even despair. Maintaining equanimity allows us to open our hearts, offering love and kindness and compassion, whilst letting go of our expectations, our control, and our attachment to a desired outcome. May you all practice and enjoy and benefit from equanimity. So taking a deep breath in for a count of five into your belly. And releasing and relaxing as you slowly breathe out for a count of five. Slowly become aware of your surroundings, feeling your feet on the floor, feeling your bottom on the chair, feeling yourself supported by the earth, whether you're sat down or lying down. Give your fingers a wiggle, give your toes a wiggle, feel your body. Notice the sounds around you. And when you're ready, bring yourself back, slowly open your eyes. And maybe have a big stretch. Nice. I like that. So how was that for you? Let me know in the comments. Was that easy? Were the parts of it that were easier than others when you were expressing equanimity for towards people that you have a difficult relationship with? Was it harder towards yourself or to your loved ones? Is it something you practice already? Or maybe you found the whole thing overwhelming, too difficult, and worry is dominating rather than acceptance. Whatever you experienced, that's okay. You can be equanimous about it. But with practice, doing these equanimity meditations and practicing it in our daily lives as well, we can find peace and acceptance. So I hope that was useful. Do leave some comments to tell me how that was for you. And if I can support you in any way, or the group can support you in any way, please reach out. And hopefully I will see some of you at 8 o'clock this evening for the Barking Tales watch party, which I will be streaming live on the group, hopefully, if I can get the technology working. Very funny, highly recommended. We could all do with a giggle, don't you think? So yeah, hopefully see you there. In the meantime, please be a sap, share, advocate, participate. Thank you. Take care. Bye.